You win on Saturday night. Notice how I say once you win, because I keep it positive, not because I'm rooting for anybody. I got to stay objective. Yes, yes. But, you know, recently I heard your coach saying that you still have a lot of guys in the division got to clear out. Hear me out, though. I'm looking at the division, and I'm thinking, okay, Darren Till, he's not ready to come see you yet because he's got to win at least a fight or two. Cannonier is going to be on the shelf until the end of the year, and then you look further down, it's like those guys are ranked kind of.
Really?
Yeah, that's what I heard. He's not coming back to the fall because he has an injury.
Oh, I heard about that, but I didn't know it was going to take him out to the end of the year.
I think that's what he said on social media.
Oh, he might get some supplements from Paulo Costa, and you might come back in 2 months.
Here's what I'm thinking, though, man. I would love to see you go up to 205, challenge John Jones, if you get past Romero, of course.
Yeah, definitely. That's what my main focus is him right now. But now there's other guys in the division. There's guys coming up, younger ones, like the Sabajian kid. And there's a few other ones. The Joker, he's got a fight coming up. Chris Weidman just came back down. I like that. So I want to clean out the division. Like, I'm not going to be one of these guys who just holds up the division for no reason. So I'm doing right by the division by being an active champion, a true champion.
Is that kind of your mission statement in 2020? I know you're not overlooking Yoel, but what do you think this year is going to bring for you?
Same as last year, just keep winning. Winning's a habit, and I keep winning.
Is there any pressure at all when it comes to you? Because obviously you're undefeated, and it's not easy for fighters to be undefeated and become champs.
It's not really about the records. Like, that's why I even chose that fight. Like, his record's shit. Like, he's got 4 losses, like 12 wins. You know, I don't say shit, but like, you know, it's records don't really mean shit to me. It's more about the challenge, you know what I mean? And for me, yes, there's pressure, but it's not about keeping my record intact. That's not what the pressure is. The pressure is, there's other things, but I like pressure. Pressure is an acquired taste. It's something that I'm used to. Even this, a lot of people who don't deal with pressure very well, they will fold. Like, this is a little bit dwindled down now, but initially when it was a lot of people like that aren't me will fold with something as little as this, but this is nothing to me. I'm just used to it. So I said it in my first UFC fight. I said, pressure makes diamonds. And I'm still shining, man.
Well, where's the hair pick? I noticed it's missing today.
Man, I stay strapped.
Here we go.
We need to keep that thing on me, man. Keep that thing on me.
Right, now, where did you get that thing? That's
pretty slick. My friend saw it. Now, I got it online. Well, you know, I got to represent. This is cultural. A lot of people don't understand, and they think some people were trying to say, like, oh, he's trying to appropriate American culture. He thinks he's American. I'm like, fuck you. You don't understand. This was way before slaves came to fucking America. This is something that you will never understand because you're ignorant. So don't disrespect my culture to those who like to disrespect it. Yeah. But this is something that I don't just wear for fun. You know, I wear to make a statement.
Yeah, they don't have any right to say anything about that to you. So I noticed you got the Leatherman jacket on. Did you see that DC just got an award from USADA, 50 clean tests, and they gave him actually a nice custom leather jacket?
I'm going to have to ask Jeff Nowitzki, how many do I have? Because I need me another jacket as well. That's pretty cool. 50 clean tests. I've been tested a lot of times, but not 50. I've been tested. I'll be close to 50. Maybe like, I'm over halfway, definitely. I'm over halfway, 20, maybe 30. But yeah, I'm gonna have to see Jeff then.
Yeah, if you see DC, check out that jacket. It's pretty slick.
He's my size as well, so I'm gonna have to see that jacket.
look at that up there, champ. Look at right behind you. Is this everything you imagine? I mean, it seems like you just burst on the scene and just ran through the division, and you did a lot of that. People were saying that you were hype and this and that, and then you took out guys that you were supposed to that were supposed to beat you.
Yeah, I'm still hype. I mean, I'm always hype. I still see it, still hear it. You know, it's just another hype job. But I like hype. Hype has been a part of my life throughout my youth and an adult, you know? And I like hype. I even like the word hype. I like to hype things up. You know, even in crump dancing, when your friends are dancing, you hype them up. You hype them up. And I love hype, you know? So I just embrace it. A lot of people are like, oh, I'm not a hype. I'm like, no, fuck that. I embrace it. So I am the hype train. I keep running people over.
Speaking of dancing, I don't know if you had a chance to hear Yoel's comments yesterday about your dance-off that you had. You know, he said that you tried. He kind of seemingly thought he got the better of you in that one.
Think
we're going to have a rematch at some point? Or?
Oh, the fight's the rematch. And like I said, he can win the battle. He needs to win something. Because he ain't winning this. So, he stole the moment. And I've been to many dance-offs and I've lost a few. So I know when someone takes the moment, you can't try and regain the moment. It's done. It's gone. But he can think that. Whatever helps him sleep at night. But, he needs something to win. So that's what he's going to be remembered for, the guy who beat me in a dance battle that I didn't even try. I mean, sometimes, you know, the lion doesn't have to roar when there's sheep around.
Do you feel respected as a champion, or is it a case where you feel you need to beat someone like Romero to get that more of that respect?
No, I think I am respected as a champion. Like, a lot of people, okay, he's for real, after they talk shit about me for so long. But for me, I still feel disrespected as well, because it's going to be part of it. It's part of it. I already expected this before I got in the UFC, before I became champion. I already expected me to be still, like, I'm going to defend this a few more times, and I'm still going to be a hype job. I'm still going to be all... They just, like, people just, whatever helps him sleep at night. Nah, he got his fights handpicked. Dude, they gave him, after this fight, they all say, he's a beast, he's this, he's that, he's like, well, nah, they gave him an old Romero. Romero in his prime, or Anderson in his prime. Anderson in his prime would have suffered the same consequences that he did to fighting me, because it's his skills. They don't understand, that was a battle of brains and the skills. I was doing to Anderson what he was doing to people who had no idea what he was doing for years. So, yeah, they're all gonna say the same shit, so I'm expecting it, I'm used to it.
How do you see the fight actually playing out in your head?
How do I see the fight playing out in my head? There's three different ways I see it ending. But the first way I feel it's gonna go is a 5-0 shutout. Oh no, I just want, my bad, oh shit, boogers. Sorry, thank you, good looking out. Let's get it out of the way.
It's gonna be a gift now, isn't it?
Yeah. There you go. It's gonna be a 5-0 shutout. That's how I see it. The rest, the other two, I'll save for myself.
Your confidence obviously is a big part of who you are. I mean, there's not many fighters that would stand up here in front of reporters and pick their nose and do what you do. Have you always been this confident? Is it something that just you grew up with, or was there a time in your life where you
didn't grow up with it? I think it's just accepting. We all pick our noses. You all take a shit, don't you? We all fucking have sex. Well, somehow in this day and age, everyone likes to. I bet you Joanna couldn't do this. Or Wenling Zhang couldn't do this. Why? It's a nipple. It's a fucking nipple. Like, do you get what I mean? I can do this because I'm a man. It's International Women's Month. But they can't do that because they're women. Everyone likes titties. Everyone sucked on titty when they was a kid. You know, so everyone likes to act like this. There's this fucking weird filter the TV and Puritan ideology has, and like, oh, let's protect the minds of the children. It's like, kids are smarter than you think. I have real conversation with kids, and I'm just like, I don't have to censor myself around you because you're smart enough to comprehend what I'm saying and how I'm saying, you know? But yeah, I'll do it again just because I know I can, because I'm a man.
Let's
shout out to the women,
that,
man.
Though.
International Women's Month.
You mentioned International Women's Month and about what the women can and cannot do. What do you
it's
think
silly.
About
it? It is. I'd have to have like a nipple fucking, like Janet Jackson, you know, to not do that. But like, it's so stupid.
What do you think about your co-main event, Whaley and Joanna?
That, I've said it before, that's fight of the night, or it's gonna be a real quick fight. Well, you guys don't understand, man. These girls, these are the two best, in the top three, top four, best fighters in the women's division. My favorites anyway, there's a few, Rose, you know, Valentina, but these two, I think it's gonna be fight of the night. I think it's gonna be a cracker, and people are sleeping on this fight. No one's really talking about this fight. I know it's because they're women and, women fighting this and that, because some people still have that ideology. Fuck, you wanna see a real girl fight? Watch the coming event, because trust me. Oof, I can't wait, man. For me, I'll be getting ready for my fight at the time, so I'll be watching it. It's not going to be me watching it, it's going to be the other guy watching it. So I won't really be as enjoying it as a fan, but I'll definitely watch it after my fight. When I get back to the hotel, when I've done my party and all that stuff, I'll definitely watch it again on ESPN Plus and then really enjoy it for what it is, because it's going to be a fucking cracker. I wish I could just watch it as a fan.
What do you make of UFC and how it promotes female fighters as opposed to other combat sports, particularly boxing?
I think they're doing better than boxing. I know Clarissa Shields is the one right now who's doing, she's doing kind of her own self-promotion. She's doing very, very good at it with her own self-promotion, but I think the UFC do a very good job. Look at what Ronda Rousey did. She fucking kicked the doors in for the women. If not for her, you guys wouldn't, like, women wouldn't really be fighting in the UFC, because Dana said no. And Dana, I feel the UFC do a good job of promoting women, yeah.
You mentioned Edmund Shahbazyan earlier. Is he a guy, maybe he's a little more soft-spoken than you were on the come-up, but is he a guy that kind of reminds you of yourself a little bit, that this young kid fighting often, people are doubting his abilities, and he goes in there and proves them wrong? Is that why you brought him up?
Are people doubting him? I don't know, because I don't really follow him like that, but I don't... He's good. He beat Brad Tavares in one round. I was there live, and I was like, that was what made me take notice. Like, oh shit, he beat a guy that I know is tough and beat him with a move that I can do as well. But he set it up nicely. One, and then a left head kick set him up nicely. So that let me know his IQ is different from the rest of these middleweights. And I'll see him later on at some point. I mean, if I was being a dick, I'd fight him. Maybe in my next fight, get him out the way. But that's a bitch move. That's a bitch move. I want the best. I want him to grow. I want him to grow as a contender. I want him to have a few more fights. So that way when I fight him, I'll fight the best version of him. I'm not trying to fight him early so that way I can get the jump on him. That's a bitch move. And you know who a bitch is.
And I'll just get a quick prediction on the fight coming up between Khabib and Tony Ferguson. What's your thoughts on that and how do you think that's going to play out?
That's a 50-50 fight for me, man. That's a 50-50 fight because they both have things that each other cancels each other out. Fuck, that's a good fight. Pray to the MMA gods that it happens this time. Is it fifth time's the charm, sixth time's the charm, whatever it is. Pray to the MMA gods. Offer a sacrifice. I'll offer a sacrifice so that way the MMA gods will be pleased and the fight will go through in April.
Just one more prediction. Kamaru Usman against Jorge Masvidal.
Mm-hmm. I'll go Kamaru on that one because that's my boy. It's a tough fight because Jorge is a beast and I'm a fan of Jorge as well, but Naija power is different, man. I see the way Kamaru does not quit. He doesn't quit. The way he goes, he just constantly. Like, even me and Jorge were working together yesterday. It's a secret. I can't tell you what for. Do you guys know? You'll never know until it comes out. But working together yesterday, and we were cordial. We were nice to each other. We were having fun. And it was cool. Even though I'm fighting this boy this weekend, you know? So this is just the game we play. Like, Kamaru's friends with guys I'm going to fight, or I have already fought. But in this fight, I'm going Kamaru.
Is it you talk-